Hello and welcome to Pictures with URLs. My name's Jeff, I'm glad you're here. Let's just jump right in. All right, in the previous videos in this pictures series, we were able to insert pictures from our local device into cells in the worksheet. In this video, we're gonna retrieve online pictures instead. Exercise one. In this exercise, I basically created a little data table that includes my book volume, the ISBN, and then this is a link to an online image. And what we wanna do is grab this online image, and we're gonna do that in the next exercise. Exercise two. Okay, so I wanna be able to type in whichever volume I'm looking for, and then I want Excel to retrieve the title, the ISBN, and the actual cover image from that URL. And here we can use our favorite lookup function, whether it's VLOOKUP, index match, or XLOOKUP, or whatever you want. In this case, I'll use XLOOKUP, equals XLOOKUP. I wanna go find this, comma, in here, comma, and I wanna return the title. Close the function and enter. Let's do the same thing with ISBN, equals XLOOKUP, I wanna go find this, comma, in here, comma, I wanna return this. Close function, enter. So far, so good. And now for the cover, equals XLOOKUP, I wanna go find this, comma, in here, comma, and I wanna return this. Close function, enter. Now that we've retrieved the correct URL, we actually need to convert that into a picture or into an image. And the way that we're gonna do that is we're gonna wrap the image function around the XLOOKUP function. And the image function takes a source URL and retrieves the image, enter. And now it's been placed in the cell. And now that this image is in the cell, we have a couple of options. One is, if we want, we can change the cell dimensions to accommodate the picture, and that would be totally fine. The other option we can do is right click, picture in cell, and say create reference. And this creates an image that's floating above the grid, and so we can put that anywhere that we want. And we're free to apply any type of picture format as well. So now if we go to 2, that should update, 3 should update, and 4 should update as well. Okay, cool. All right, hey, thanks so much for joining me. Hopefully this was helpful. Have a great day. Hey, Excel user, if you ever need to create summary reports, check out my Pivot Table for Beginners video. It starts at the beginning and shows how to store the data transactions in a table and then how to summarize those transactions with a Pivot Table report. I hope it helps unlock the incredible power of Pivot Tables.
This video is a production of Excel University.